Hi, my loves. Thank you so much for visiting my channel. I hope that you are having a beautiful and amazing day. If you're new to my channel, welcome. And if you are returning, thank you for all of your continued love and support. I really appreciate it. Please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This is a timeless collective reading for all signs. Whenever you hear the message is when you're meant to receive it. But today is special. It is the Lionsgate portal, so it's August 8th. I did post earlier today, but the upload from earlier was from late last night. But I want to connect with the energies right now, actually on August 8th. I want you guys to know that with the Lionsgate portal, it opens today, okay? For the remainder of this month, I really think that you should take advantage of this beautiful energy. This is definitely a time for you to grow, to ascend, to manifest, to evolve. Venus is in retrograde. We're in the pre-shadow phase of Mercury being in retrograde, which is going to start on the same day as Virgo season, I think August 16th. We also have a super moon, which is going to be a full moon in Pisces on August 30th. So this is like a very just cosmic month. You may feel like a lot of things are going backwards. Some of you, there are things from the past that you want to revisit, that you want to heal. You may not necessarily be going back to certain people or situations, but maybe you want to just kind of heal a past version of yourself. A lot of inner child healing, just things like that, okay? But there is for sure lots of revelations, epiphanies, a lot of growth, new beginnings coming. I think I said yesterday, the things that you do right now are going to really be setting the tone for like the next 7 to 8 year karmic cycle for you. So be very mindful, be intentional. That's why today, I've been out all day. I started my day just being very intentional. I said, what would I like for the next 8 months of my life to look like? How would I want that day to look? And I went out today and I did things that I could see myself doing for quite some time, in hopes that it would manifest things that are a vibrational match for where I am. So, you know, if you didn't have a chance to do that today, and it doesn't matter if you see this on any day, it could be any day, just keep that in mind. Being intentional, being mindful is very important for you to manifest. So the bottom of the deck, the Two of Swords, is in the reverse. Amazing. So you're not halted, you're not stagnant, you're not at a crossroads. Even if you are, it's like you should have an ability right now to really tap in. It's like you're walking by faith and not by sight. And I feel like that's what's truly necessary for a lot of people right now. You're going to have to allow God to guide you at this time. A lot of things are not going to make sense. Like I said, this is a very cosmic month. We have this retrograde energy here, which, you know, can be very triggering for many people. There's just a lot of things happening, and you don't have to give too much power to the past or anything like that. But what I will say again is to just make sure that you are being intentional. Sorry, guys. I'm just trying to adjust the light a little bit in here if I can. Sorry. I'm so sorry. I should have done this before. I don't think it got that much better, but yeah. So the Hierophant is here. Definitely ascension, okay? Growth, new opportunities. Seven of Swords here and the Seven of Cups. Wow. So there's an energy that was around you, or it is around you, or maybe it's coming in. It's deceitful, it's confusing, it's conflicting, all right? You could have options coming towards you, and someone could be in the background trying to do something that's a little shady, so that you're unable really to move forward to experience all these different options or opportunities or offers that's coming towards you. So right now you need to make sure that you're not being complacent. Somebody wants you to be complacent, okay? Just don't allow yourself, don't even worry about who, what other people, what their ill intentions are. Make sure you're just not falling in the trap, okay? Eight of Wands, yeah. something is coming quickly for you. The Wheel of Fortune. You have options. There's offers. There's opportunities. The next 8 weeks are going to be very significant. Look at that. Lots of fire here. Six of Wands, Ace of Wands. There's a very, very new, passionate, bright, like, beginning. You're going to have this burning desire to do something new, to go somewhere new, to experience something new, to just, it's just new energy here. But again, you have, there's a spiritual battle, a spiritual test here. Conflict, jealousy, envy, competition, chaos. It's all around you, but you're being tested right now. You have to get to the top. It's like there's this flame, this torch that you have to get to. And what I'm really getting from this card is not so much just competition and jealousy. It's just that may be the energy that's coming towards you, like the evil eye from your enemies. But you also are being watched and monitored by your spiritual team. They are trying to assess and evaluate how bad do you want this new opportunity. And what you're going to have to do is put the work in to prove that you're worthy of actually having this Midas touch energy, because that's what you're tapping into. Look at this, the High Priestess and the Four of Wands. Your intuition right now is being strengthened. It's heightened intuition, more clarity, more insight, self-awareness here, where it's like, again, you have to really trust your faith and your intuition. It does not matter what's around you here that may be deceitful at all. It doesn't matter. It just does not matter. You have to have your eye on the prize at all times. You have the Ace of Wands, the Eight of Wands, Six of Wands, the Four of Wands, the Five of Wands. So that's four, five, six. We don't have the Seven of Wands yet, and then the Eight of Wands. With the Ace of Wands, this is all fire. So that's Leo season. Today is the 8th. August 16th is going to be a new moon in Leo. So like I said, Lionsgate portal is today. In the next 8 days, we're going to have a Leo new moon. You need to be waking up every single day, concentrating on what are you trying to manifest. I mean, I would say for sure the next 8 days, the number 8 is very significant. The next 8 days, every single day. Really cleanse, clear, detox, purge, plan, okay, strategize. Just try to be your best self. There's a lot of new energy that is coming in, all right? It's time for you to heal, and here's the Eight of Pentacles. The Four of Swords is here. This Four of Swords is falling underneath this Seven of Swords. So like I said, some of you right now, there is an energy around you or within you, and it's deceiving. You may be feeling let me say this, pre-shadow in Mercury retrograde. Some of you are being deceived into thinking that you need to slow down. You need to rest. You need to retreat. You need to separate from something or someone. Something here is an illusion. That's why the Seven of Cups is here. Something is an illusion. Don't be fooled by this outdated thinking or conditioning. Right now is the time for you to be working really, really hard. And it may seem like it's a struggle, okay? You're going to feel burned out. Like it's a struggle to balance everything that you're about to try to balance right now. But it's necessary for you to, in the end, receive some type of good karma. Right now, you may not feel like waking up early. You may not feel like staying up late. You may not feel like doing a lot of things right now, okay? But that is just because we're in this retrograde energy, okay? Your relationships are being tested and challenged a lot. This is your relationship, first and foremost, with yourself, your relationship with your friends, your family, the relationship that you have with coworkers, business partners, your relationship with money, all these different relationships, okay, that are very key to your life and your lifestyle are being challenged right now. And you may feel like, you know what, forget it, I'll just give up, okay? This is not the time to give up. You're going to have to learn now how to heal while you're actually under, like, this fire, this flame is burning around you. You're still going to have to somehow walk. How can I put this? Like, it's like crossing the burning sands. You know that it's hot. You know it's hot. But you know you can't stay where you are. So you're going to have to cross the burning sands. You have no choice. All right. For sure. Ooh. Either there's a divine masculine that's really getting kicked into gear right now, or this is you, or you're doing everything to manifest a divine masculine. Or if you are like a divine feminine, either you're doing a lot to manifest a divine masculine, or you are healing your own divine masculine energy so that you are able to really create something. But I feel strongly that there's a divine masculine out here, just the collective in general, that is really looking for like a feminine energy here, Queen of Cups, and they're ready to go into overdrive. Oh my goodness, the King and the Queen of Cups is here. Wow. So if some of you are in like a soulmate twin flame connection, you're being tested 100%. Some of you have been trying to manifest a partnership or a relationship, and it may seem like everything is going up in flames right now because Venus is in retrograde and Mercury is in retrograde. So this could be a time where exes come back. You are triggered. Like I said, you're going to be tested and tried, and you have to prove yourself is true. Right now, right when you want to break down and give up, you're going to have to work harder to get through this breakthrough, because as you actually get rid of a lot of these burdens here, people, places, things, situations, these burdens here that cause you to have this confusion, is making way for a breakthrough. Also, too, somebody is for sure trying to play on the mind, the body, the spirit, the emotions of a masculine to confuse them. All right. This could be someone from this masculine's life, or if you are a divine feminine, you could have someone in your life that is attacking you and whoever this masculine is that is currently in your life or coming into your life. Okay. So you're going to have to be very careful at this time. Like I said, it's going to seem like you cannot balance everything that's happening. It's an illusion. You are literally about to have the most amazing partnership to manifest in your life. This is the time for you to play chess, not checkers. There has to be a level of strategy here. And you're learning to do things with more skill and trusting your intuition to do it. You have the High Priestess here and the Four of Wands. I'm telling you, there is like a twin flame soulmate connection for some of you. It is for sure being manifested, but you're being tested. It's how bad do you want it? Do you really know what it's like to be married? Do you really know what a kingdom marriage entails? Do you really know what it means for God to be at the head and always at the center of your relationship? Do you really understand that? Some of you've done a lot of healing, and you, with the Seven of Swords, also speaking of hiding, you've been hiding. You've been healing and hiding. Somebody here is ready to choose their person. They're ready to choose their mate. And you very well could be someone's choice. But there is some type of inner child healing, some type of outdated beliefs that you have to put an end to. And as soon as you do this, there's an ascension that happens, and it opens you up to this amazing partnership. This is amazing. So right now, Lionsgate portal, somebody is for sure manifesting like the love of this lifetime for themselves. This person could already be in your life, or they're about to enter your life. Some of you, someone is coming back. Take it however it resonates. A lot of you, I know, my collective, that you're not really interested in the past. Keep in mind, though, this could be someone from the past that you've just known, you've crossed paths with. You may not have ever been in a relationship with them. I don't know why this Emperor is here. This could be this masculine that's really taking charge to manifest this relationship. That's what I'm really picking up here. I feel like there is definitely, this is all masculine energy that I'm getting here. And then with this fire energy, definitely Leo, Aries, Sagittarius like energy. But somebody is manifesting an emotionally fulfilling connection, and they want this to move forward. And I feel that someone may have been confused. This masculine also may have been hiding the fact from you that they were really going through something deep trying to heal themselves. And now it's like the only thing that's needed is for someone to drop the last bit of their baggage or their burdens. And boom, all of us, there's about to be just a crazy breakthrough here. I'm telling you, I can feel it. It's like really major. Seriously, somebody is about to run to you. You're going to run right into this person very soon. Hear no evil, see no evil, speak no evil. Keep your thoughts and your intentions as pure and high vibing as possible. The Wheel of Fortune, it's the number 10. Something is completing. Between August and October, there's a lot of new beginnings here. And whatever you start is going to be victorious. Also, another thing too, a lot of people talk about during retrograde. Don't start anything during retrograde or whatever the case may be. This retrograde energy is going to be here through like September. Okay. I believe that Venus went retrograde like sometime in July. And hold on, because I have my handy dandy. It's something about August through October. When did Venus went retrograde July 22nd. Mercury is going retrograde August 23rd. All right. And then Venus retrograde ends September 3rd. Mercury retrograde ends September 15th. Now, Mercury retrograde ends September 15th. And then usually there's like a post-shadow phase, which may take us all the way through the rest of September. So let's just say, but by the time October comes, Libra season, it's gonna be on for you. So right now, you need to know you're being tested. Know that you're being tested. Don't worry about anything dark. It's already being handled by your spiritual team. Every single day for the next 8 weeks, you manifest like crazy. Do you hear me? You hear me? You got me? Okay. Every single day at the crack of dawn, you get up. Some of you, it's a weight loss journey, whatever it is. Every single day you get up and you chase whatever this dream is that you have. This moon, I'm hearing the crack of dawn every day. When the sun goes up, when the moon comes out, listen, you need to get to whatever this is, because something for you over the course of the next 4, 6, 8 weeks is going to drastically change. Something happened in July. And you may have come to the realization that you need to take time out to heal. What it was is Venus went retrograde for a lot of you. Venus went retrograde and all of a sudden you started experiencing turbulence in relationships. You're losing friends, family. The truth is being exposed, whatever. Now Mercury retrograde, how you communicate, how you react, how you respond. You know, are you going to keep letting people from the past keep coming into your life, slowing you down? All of those things are happening. But this is like a major test. You got July out here, August. Virgo season is a time for you to work hard, all right? And then you go into Libra season, justice. The scales have to be balanced. But when things are balanced out, it's going to take into account how hard have you been working right now to let go of the things that don't bring you reciprocity. Have you been overgiving? Have you been undergiving? Have you been lazy? Like, what have you been putting out? If you've been putting the work in right now, and I'm seeing for sure like a masculine, somebody here, if you've been waiting on a job opportunity or any type of breakthrough, you may not see it happening right now, but it's all about the effort. Are you putting the effort in? Somebody is working sun up, sun down in the dark. You may not even know how hard someone is truly working, but I'm telling you, when these energies switch and these planets go back direct, everything is going to come in at once. And there's going to be nothing but passion, strong desires, new creative projects, a third eye that's wide open, victory, success. This is redemption here. Somebody feels like nothing is moving right now. It's we have this happen every year. Mercury retrograde, it's like a what do you call that thing? Like a slingshot. You're being yanked all the way back, and boom, all of a sudden you're just gonna go right into something amazing when things go back direct. But what are you doing? Spirit is looking to see, what are you doing right now in the shadows? How are you working on your own personal shadow? You have the Judgment card here and Death, two cards of Scorpio. So Scorpio season comes right after Libra season. Libra season, things are going to balance out. Scorpio season, that's the rebirth. That's the transformation. This is when you come completely out of your shell. This is when you truly ascend. And I feel like everybody's going to see it. Some of you, you're going through like some major type of glow up right now. Yeah. And this fall, some of you, you're really going to be falling in love. You're going to be so happy and so free when it comes to your partnerships and your relationships. Some of you, you've had connections that you're taking the time out right now. Maybe you're not prioritizing love right now of other people. And that's a good thing, because there's no more illusions. Eight of Swords, but it's in the reverse. There's no more illusions here. You have illusions here about who you need to work with. Spirit is telling you now, there's something here that you don't need to put any effort into. You don't need to work with a particular group or a person, or if there's a group or person that has been working against you to try to have go through like financial issues or anything like that. This painful situation is finally coming to an end. Somebody has been obsessed with turning your life upside down, especially your finances. This is about to come to an end. And in Virgo season, this Virgo hermit energy, this is the time now for you to be learning, going within, doing the soul work, the introspection, the healing, dotting all your I's, crossing all of your T's. Like, you cannot allow whatever this is, this in the shadows, to stop you. Because this is all good energy. It is. The Hangman. You may feel delayed, but this delay is only taking place so that you can go through this awakening. Something is not passing you by. It feels like you're bored. You're discontent. But the Ace of Pentacles is coming. I'm telling you, you feel like something is not moving. You're like, this job offer is not coming. This relationship is not coming. If you're trying to conceive, you're like, something here is not happening. Yes, it is. It's going to happen in divine timing. And that divine timing is right around the corner. I see it. I'm telling you, a lot of you, like, Spirit is about to completely blow your mind. And you don't need to be worried about, well, I lost that opportunity before. It doesn't matter, because where you were before, even last year, you're in a much better place now. Page of Swords and the Knight of Pentacles. This is research and development. Like I said, this has you bored. You're like, well, I'm constantly learning and I'm growing and I'm developing, but I just don't see anything happening. Boom, it's coming. Here's the upgrade. The world and the Hierophant, God is about to close something out and give you a major upgrade. I'm telling you, it's redemption season for you. You're going to be sitting real pretty very soon. Very, very stable. That Nine of Pentacles was in the reverse before. Some of you, somebody has definitely done something to try to ruin your business, your finances, or whatever the case is. But I feel like I'm hearing help is on the way. Somebody is coming to your aid, your rescue, or you're going to be helping somebody. And this is something that's being spiritually guided. Some of you could meet someone traveling, or there's distance between you and another person. I'm hearing in my head right now, Rihanna, we fell in love in a hopeless place. So somebody here is down on their luck. And you may all of a sudden meet this boss, this entrepreneur. Somebody here could be a Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, a masculine for sure. You have a very grounded, stable, and I feel like a very highly spiritual feminine out here. When these two people come together, it's going to be like mind blowing. there's a disconnect. If you know this person right now, there's a disconnect. I don't feel like it's a separation. I feel like there's just a disconnect in the energy. And it's only because of what's happening cosmically. That's it. Seven of Pentacles, yeah. Somebody is trying to rebuild after some type of interference. This is that Venus retrograde energy. Mercury retrograde. Somebody is reliving a past experience. But they're going to pick up and go. It's like if someone has been hurt by something in the past, they're making a decision to say, this is the very last time this will ever hurt me. It could be you. It could be another person. It could be feminine, masculine. But somebody's like, this is the last time this will ever take advantage of me. I just looked at the TV and on Netflix, it said a perfect story. This is going to be your perfect story. Because somebody's like, this is the last time. This chapter is closed here. And I feel that God is pleased with you finally deciding that you're done with something. Like, this is the last time I'm going to deal with someone who is still involved in another situation. This is the last time I'm going to put up with this third party situation. This is the last time I'm going to cry about this person, this job, this situation. This is the last time that you're going to allow something to cause you stress, fear, pain, anxiety, or to be burdened. There is no more work for you to put into this situation. The Three of Pentacles is in the reverse. You're coming to realize that you cannot manifest something where you are. This disappointment is needed. You need to see with these Three of Cups here that there is a situation, a reunion, or something here. You have two threes here, five, seven, nine. The Three of Pentacles is in the reverse and the Three of Swords. There's a situation that's been causing you heartbreak or interference. You need to get in your mind clearly. Do not try to make this situation work again. Don't. Okay? It's causing you the type of anxiety, sleepless nights, fear, and insomnia, or whatever the case is, light depression. This feeling of regret, rejection. Some of you have like a rejection or abandonment wound. There's a situation in your life that keeps triggering that same wound. And you need to let it go once and for all, because it's like a familiar spirit, some type of, it's an energy, okay? And it's trying to pull on your heartstrings to get you to feel sorry for it or something like that. But what's around the corner for you is this peace, this balance, this harmony. Wow, look at that. Knight of Cups. Oh, baby, there's a love that's coming in that is going to blow you away. Ten of Cups, Ten of Pentacles, Knight of Cups. This is you getting love from an angel. Nine of Cups, Ten of Cups. This is your ultimate wish fulfillment. There is nothing. Page of Cups. You don't have to hold on to anything. Somebody wanted you out in the cold. They wanted you to suffer, especially financially. And the only reason why that happened is because you made a different choice in love. You could have someone in your life right now that's trying to cause chaos and conflict for you. If you let this person back into your life, they're going to do the same thing to you once again. This is someone who has already had you very, very on guard, very paranoid, fearful, in this wounded-like energy. Yeah, King of Pentacles here, Four of Pentacles. Somebody here you need to hold back. This could be someone that's very money hungry, greedy, selfish, extremely controlling. You need to hold back from this energy. Because this person's, what they tend to do is they don't allow you to be free spirited. They don't allow you to be confident, sexy, ambitious, bold, courageous. They don't like that. Whenever you take a step to move in a new direction, to love yourself and be this divine feminine, you can't do that with this person. So for some of you too, if it's a third party situation, you need to realize that there's a person that is not going to make you an official emperor or empress, meaning they're not going to marry you. They're not going to enter into an actual partnership or commitment with you. And therefore, you need to leave it alone. This person is conflicted about their past, because in their past, most likely they have a child with someone. Or they have something that they are growing or developing with another person. You need to go within to see that this devil, this force of, this habit in your life, this addiction or obsession with this person, or with the idea of something moving forward with this person, it's keeping you stuck. So now your spirit is being tested, your spiritual strength. do you have the strength to actually move forward and have some type of boundary, self-worth, dignity about yourself to say no more? Will you allow someone to have you in this mental conflict? So divine intervention is coming here, but you still have your free will. Once again, you're gonna have to walk by faith and not by sight. You know it's something better. This could be a past person. It could be someone in your life right now. You know there is something better. And for some of you, there's a situation that could be in your life, or when it comes into your life, it's going to improve over time. And I feel like it's going to improve like very quickly, but you're still being you just have to be able to test the spirit here. King of Swords and the Fool card. I feel like Archangel Michael is coming in saying it's safe for you to take this leap of faith because you have the clarity, the wisdom, the insight, the awareness that you need now about who and what you need to protect yourself from. There's something coming in because the Three of Wands is here that you need to protect yourself from in order for you to have justice. And you receive justice by walking away. You receive justice by going on your own divine path. Okay? The Three of Cups is here with the Ten of Swords. Yeah, this is the end of this situation of you wondering if it's time for you to reunite with somebody. The answer is no. I don't know who needs to hear that, but you constantly wondering, do you need to still talk to this ex-friend? Do you need to hang out with this family member? Do you need to go back to that job? Do you need to hang out with this lover? Is this person going to come back into your life? No. Okay? No. No, no, and no. At least for right now, no. You need to just tell yourself no. If it's going to change, let it change. But don't try to convince yourself of something that you can't actually see. You can see the intentions of people. Yeah, there are some situations that have potential. Okay? But it requires work, hard work, and clear intentions. I'm sorry. This is like good. Something is on. And I feel like somebody is getting into, it doesn't matter if you're male or female, this masculine, fiery energy where you're passionate. That's that Leo energy. Well, and some of you, you just need to say no. Like, no, I'm not doing that. You have here anger and key. Something is possibly going to make you angry, or you're going to finally realize that you're really being taken advantage of or done wrong in a situation. There's maybe some type of pent up anger, submerged emotions that you have about a person or a situation. You need to let it go, but it's actually the key to your success, because if you tap into this pain and let it fuel your purpose, there's a lot of new doors that are going to open to you. You're going to start finding solutions to things. Some of you, you're going to realize that you're really doing something by yourself, and maybe someone is going to let you down, and it's going to make you so angry and upset. You're going to go and force yourself into some new spaces and places, and new doors are going to open for you. It seems like, even looking at this tower card here, sometimes when we refuse to make changes, like divine intervention will come in and it'll force a change, and it's not always pretty. Some of you, you just won't stop going back to something. You won't stop wishing on the same star for something that's not for you, and it's going to be permanently taken away because there has to be some kind of a boundary between you and this devilish energy. This is codependency. It's toxicity. It's having some type of obsession with a situation here. Someone is not fully releasing a part of their shadow. There's a part of your inner child that's just not healing. You're still holding on to anger, disappointment, pain, the potential of a situation or something. It's, you're gonna have to finally just surrender whatever this is. Like, stand your ground and just say, there's nothing more that I can do here. And I feel like when you do that, all of a sudden something comes in. Look at this. Single life and soulmates. You're going to be sad that you're going to have to get rid of something or someone. You're going to be disappointed because there's a change that's coming. It's not a change that you really want to make. Yeah, but there's a lesson here. This is a divine feminine for sure, a woman. You're learning some type of lesson here about contracts. Ooh. with a man. You guys are learning lessons for sure about relationships. And karmic justice is coming. You're going to be able to celebrate. Here is the wheel. This is what's happening to you in the future. What's happening in the future is there is an ending and a new beginning, death. There's a transformation and a rebirth. Okay? You may find yourself single, but you have a very rare gift. Okay? You can tap into the Most High to manifest what you want. You can manifest the soulmate connection that you want, for sure. You're going to be walking yourself into like your actual true soul family, new soul contracts. This is a connection that's going to help you grow. It's a very healthy, happy, harmonious type of connection. And you and the person that you're connecting with are both most likely single. And you both have a unique gift. You guys together, you have a gift to attract money, power, success, wealth. With the use of you being aligned with your higher self. It's not you attracting things because of anything low vibrational. You and someone are both true, like, divine beings. You're earth angels. But you have to learn some type of lesson here about not allowing yourself to be sad over situations that are just not for you. Okay? You have woman, man contracts and then learning. It's like, you and someone both, there's a man and a woman out here, divine feminine and masculine, who are being tested. You're looking for knowledge. You're looking for information. Some of you, for sure, you're going to go into some type of partnership. It's time for you to make it official. In the future, you and someone, after some type of ending happens and you receiving karmic justice, you and a person are going to make something official, and you're going to have so much to celebrate. Something here is faded, but there's a huge turning point. Your person is single, like you. A lot of you, you need to stop telling yourself that you have to settle for a person that is in another connection because of some type of spiritual tie that you have to them. This is some type of fragmented belief that you have. That it's okay for a person's energy to be split between you and someone else. Somebody here has too many options. They're lying. Okay? And this is a person who is a risk taker. They're always looking for the next best thing. And here, you're waiting on this person. And for what? You're waiting on something or someone. You're hoping to hear news, but you're putting your life on hold for this. But at the same time, the person that... This is so weird. It's like you're in two situations at once. The connection that's for you with this angel here, it's going to happen at the perfect time. Divine intervention is taking place. Again, there's going to be a lot of fortune and favor. Oh, like a really happy surprise is coming. But you have to actually learn the difference in waiting for someone and preparing for someone. Some of you are waiting for a karmic person that's going to come in. They're going to make you very sad and disappoint you. And what you should actually be doing is, like with the owl card here, getting yourself out of survival mode, learning the hard lessons, accepting that something did not work out, doing the deep shadow work, and actually preparing yourself for a connection that is divinely guided and protected. Some of you at this point, it's like you should be tired of just barely hanging on. There's a situation that you're in with someone. It's making you very angry, okay? Because someone is always in between worlds. And because of this situation, you're becoming burned out. Somebody is not telling the truth. But it's weird here. It's not weird. There's more than one energy here where it's like you're dealing with two different people and neither one of them are telling you the truth. One person is hiding the fact that they're working very, very hard to prepare a life with you, while you have another person that is working very hard to hide the fact that they never planned to have a life with you, but now they want to come back into your life. somebody is definitely working behind the scenes though to try to come in. They feel like you're the missing piece to some puzzle in their life, okay? They could be changing at this time, but it's somebody is still like telling you something or doing something that is not, it's still just, it's not what you want. Something here is just not what you want. And I feel like the big lesson here is understanding that when you're torn between more than one path, you have the choice to manifest exactly what you want. Something, you're trying to balance a situation out that's just not meant for you. Because you're not seeing the full picture. Like I said, there's something here. It's an illusion. You're being tricked. If it's not you, it's someone you're dealing with. Somebody can't see something. But you also have someone here who they can actually see something that is not seen by the naked eye, will say. And they're taking time out to heal. Some of you, you have a person in your life that is actually doing the shadow work and the healing. They may tell you that they need a break from you or this connection. It's not because they don't like you. They don't want to be with you. It seems like somebody actually has, and this is why it's so confusing. Somebody out here does have dignity, honor, integrity. Somebody is willing to tell you that they don't know for sure if they can give you what you want, but they're working behind the scenes to make sure that they can give you what you want. Okay. Them telling you this is going to be sad. It's going to make you sad because you're going to feel like this is, it's just not what you want to hear. You're going to feel like it's an inconvenient truth, but this is someone being honest with you, and it's going to allow you to still be happy, go out, be single, date, and have good mental health. Okay. And it may just, this could be a temporary separation for some of you. But then some of you need to be mindful that you have a person who is going to come in and tell you that everything is perfect and they can't work to be with you, but this person is in between worlds. They're barely hanging on, okay? They're angry because of another situation that they're in, and they're really coming to you as like a backup plan. Both of these, neither one of these situations looks ideal, okay? The point is, though, one has potential, and one you need to just leave alone for good. You'll know who is who. Because, I mean, you can deal with a person and they not have everything together. But again, it's their intentions. They have the intentions to bring about happiness in your life. All right. So right now, you need to be open to love and going out, having a good time, whether you're single, you know, dating people or whatever. But something here that you know is not what you want long term, you just shouldn't really entertain it. Especially if a person is not showing you that they're planning their life with you in mind. You can meet a person that, you know, it doesn't seem like they're what you want based on their current circumstances and conditions. But behind the scenes, this person could be doing everything to manifest the most incredible life for you. All right. That's why you have to test the spirit. Because it feels like somebody here is going to come in and make it seem like they're just ready to have this amazing life with you. And they could look like they have it all together on paper. What you may not know, though, is that karma is about to hit this person. And all they're trying to do is secure a life with you because they know that karma is about to hit. This person who was on top is about to be on bottom. Okay. The last shall be first and the first shall be last. That person is going to come in and try to sneak into your life to tap into your good fortune because you have a rare gift to manifest blessings and abundance. You have favor over your life. this person is about to lose all of their favor, most likely because they've lost you. You have another person that does not seem to have great favor happening for them right now, but they're about to come into a string of luck and a lot of blessings. Their life could change. It's two people that's coming towards you. Both of them, their lives are about to change overnight. So you have to know, you can't only look at how circumstances and conditions are today. You may really want to look at a person's character and their intentions. You can meet a person today that's the most attractive, most wealthy person, and you think that you're going to have the most amazing life. They could go broke tomorrow. Whole face could be burned off. You know what I'm saying? Like, you just don't know. They could have a pending legal situation or anything, and they could lose everything. And you could go and meet a person, doesn't seem like they have much. They could hit the lottery and still may have really good intentions, you know. So I'm telling you, test it, because you're being tested right now. I mean, really tested. It's really good energy, though. I mean, forgiveness here is here, and unconditional love, yeah, but something here is forbidden. You're going to be tempted. Something is going to try to trick you out of your spot for sure. Somebody is trying to attach themselves to you. You have here secret admirer. Yeah, somebody who you're not talking to, they're watching you. This is a very controlling, toxic person. They're watching you. And you have really big changes happening in your life because you're working on, look at this. You're working on self-love and self-worth. So huge changes are coming. I told you, August through October, unconditional love should be your focus. And this is unconditional love of self. Like, getting over the regret, the pain of you dealing with a person that most likely was forbidden. Someone that you dealt with in the past, they are forbidden from your life, but they are caught in a situation with someone who they should have seen as forbidden. They're in pain. They're suffering with someone else, and they want to come in. This person is watching you from afar. Yeah, look at this. Watching you. Green-eyed monster. Expect a phone call. This person is closed off, and they're not saying much. But they're in pain and deep regret. So a lot of you, this is a past person. They're in pain and deep regret. Ooh, twin flame. You have a twin flame that's longing for you. It's a past life connection. All right. Here is wrong timing. So some of you, you're meeting the love of your life, and it may seem like the wrong time because something in their life or your life right now is not as stable and secure. But again, it says here, take time out to relax. Whatever is doesn't seem like it's working right now, it has the potential to work because there's unconditional love here. Man, I'm telling you, some of you really thought you were with your twin flame, and your twin flame is someone that you're like friend zoning right now, or you're not talking to, or you haven't met. This person is in deep regret over you. They're not your person. For a lot of you, they're not. It feels like you may feel like this person is your person because they're projecting so much energy onto you. All of the energy that they're projecting, though, comes from them thinking about you nonstop. This person's constantly overthinking about how much regret they're in. They're sorry and they miss you. This karmic partner, they want a commitment with you because they went the wrong way. If it's not you, the person that you're connecting with, that person, they have a karmic in their energy. That's Mercury retrograde for you, though. Mercury retrograde and Venus retrograde. This is like the time where every single ex is going to try to reach out to you. Projection, manipulation, spell work. They're going to do whatever they have to do. A lot of these exes, they are connected to various entities and principalities that you need to be mindful of. Like, you have more than one option. And for some of you, these issues that you're having, it's causing breakups and separations, even with people that you're supposed to be with. Wow. I'm telling you. Oh, this is so cute. But somebody here, they're not gone. If you're separated from someone right now, it's only a matter of time before they come in offering union. They want to spend quality time together with you. And they see themselves. They want you in this. They want the two of you to live together, have a family, build a life together, everything. Like, they're going to come in and say this very soon. But it really feels like, for people who are truly like on like some type of twin flame journey. Yeah. New love. Someone new is coming in. Or this person that is coming in. This is redemption for you. The newer love in your life. Yeah. Flow. Trust the process here. Finances. Someone is working their finances. Or you can expect a lot of wealth and blessings. Somebody wants to live with you. They want there to be union. This person loves spending quality time. But you have a choice. You have to. And it seems like for some of you, you're going to receive like such a huge blessing with this past life twin flame connection that's in your life or about to come into your life. But the blessing only comes if you know how to let go of this controlling toxic person that's also in your energy. Somebody that is in your energy heavy, they are very much forbidden, but they're your temptation. This is somebody that you have a lot of fire, passion, and desire for. And you may have been addicted to the idea of something changing with this person and them giving you wish fulfillment. You're very drawn to this person. But it's like you have good karma coming. Yeah, divine feminine. You have good karma coming, possibly with a fire sign. That's it could be a soulmate or a twin flame. And that's why all this, there's a fire sign masculine out here for some of you, or they have fire heavily aspected in their chart that's going through an awakening. This person could be going through like a dark night of the soul right now, but when you make a choice to let go of the past fully, it's going to make space for this person. Some of you, the reason why there's still these issues in your love life, you have not fully let go of someone. And I mean, it could be a new person in your life. You need to let them go because maybe the past person is supposed to come back in new energy, or you just haven't met the person you're meant to be with. However, something or someone is in your energy that needs to be evicted ASAP. Like, that's just the truth. Yeah, look at this. Conflicts. You're confused on how to move forward in a situation, but Spirit is saying you need to look at something differently here and take action and understand that it's safe for you to love. It's safe for you to take a leap of faith. There are signs here that are guiding you. Okay, it could be showing up in your dreams. In your dreams, you're being guided to the right person, place, thing, or situation. But you have to be willing to sacrifice something that's just not for you. I can't say that enough. And until you get comfortable with setting boundaries and finding the good in goodbye, you're going to be stuck. This is exciting. I like it. I don't know what else to pull. Let's just pull a few of our like romance cards. Because something is good. Something good is coming in your romantic life. Well, for one, freedom. And look at that. It says, watch out. You have freedom coming. Okay. You have a connection coming where you can be your truest self with someone. All right. They are the best part of your life, or you're the best part of their life. But this person, the two of you are both going through a spiritual awakening, or you will go through a spiritual awakening. The reason why for some of you, if you're already involved with someone, it seems like the connection is slowing down or there's a separation. It's because the two of you are going through a spiritual awakening where you are freeing yourselves from any and everything that could be blocking this connection, so that you can truly enjoy quality time with one another and go like onto this new journey where you can explore life and have a brand new chapter with this person. This is someone that you have known from a past life. You're getting to know this person now, or you're about to. But you have to forgive and heal from things from your past. And again, watch out. Somebody from your past or someone in your life or in your energy right now is gossiping. They're being envious, jealous. They're causing chaos and conflict because you're about to fall in love and have this amazing harvest season. Yeah, so you need to be careful of your soul tie. Some of you, you have a very unhealthy soul tie with someone, but you have an extremely beautiful soul tie with somebody else. Money and finances is here. It says money is among the top five things that couples fight over or individuals stress about. Unresolved financial matters may be affecting this relationship. All right. So somebody could be having financial issues right now. Test the spirit. Ego versus self. Don't be in your ego about another person's. Don't find yourself pocket watching for somebody else. Because you can have it all today and you can lose it all today. Words of affirmation and partnership. In a true partnership, even when someone is going through something, you have to still be able to act with emotional stability and have integrity and be able to talk that person through whatever they're going through to remind them that they still have great purpose, even if there is some type of issue, obstacle, or challenge that they are facing. Because that's what you would want someone to do with you. That's what allows you to have true vulnerability in a partnership. You having words of affirmation, like really understanding all of the love languages with someone. Being able to express your true self. For a person to come and tell you that they are having issues with family or with finances, that's major. All right. So some of you right now, you could be having a checkpoint moment and divergent dreams is here. So somebody could be making like a career change, or somebody could be considering relocating, or whatever the case may be. But this goes back to the energy of someone is working hard behind the scenes to try to ensure that they can have some kind of partnership with you. So it's important for you to be vulnerable enough now to have a check-in with whoever this person is, or if this happens in the future, don't be afraid to say, okay, so where exactly do we stand? What's happening? What's going on? And if you, for some of you, if you don't do this, some of you, somebody could ghost you, or you may ghost this person. I don't think you need to do that though, because this could be your happily ever after, and it's going to bring you great peace of mind. These are mature relationships that's happening. Everything is not, like I say, Marvin Gaye and lingerie all the time. That may just be a season. Everyone has a hard knock or a season of hardship. Spirit is testing you now. Are you only operating out of ego? Because when you didn't have it all, most likely this karmic person that you think is your twin flame, they probably threw you to the wolves and left you out in the cold and went to pick what they thought was a better version. Now you're being tested. Are you going to do that to somebody in your life? For some of you, if the story fits, are you going to go out and just only act out of ego, looking for, you want the best person on paper, but like I said, but they're piss poor spiritually. Everybody's looking for somebody wealthy now, realizing that some of these wealthy people, they're spiritually bankrupt. So what is that going to do for you on your spiritual journey? Nothing. You'll be in the poorhouse with them. Yeah. Somebody's going to receive unexpected income. Yeah. And this is going to be the end of someone trying to steal from the privileged lady. So some of you, you're a divine feminine. This karmic masculine is constantly trying to steal your energy, or like get in your energy, or get back into your energy, because they know that they are about to have, they're about to descend and have a decline in their life and their finances. They're trying to come back to attach to you for all the wrong reasons. All right. So that's just a little message. I hope that that resonated. Right now, the energy for the collective is be passionate about what you want, because yeah, you are at a crossroads. You have more than one option in your career, your finances, and your love life. And you're being asked right now to use your free will to, you know, understand doing things that are in alignment with your higher self to manifest exactly what you want. You do not have to settle. All right. You don't have to wait on anyone. You don't have to go back to anyone. You don't have to settle. You can have and do exactly what you want. But this is a balancing act that's taking place. It says you may be putting all of your time and energy into one area and neglecting other areas that need your immediate attention. Some of you, you're putting too much focus on love, and you need to be focused more on your career, your health, finances, your friendships, your family. Some of you are not focusing on love at all, and you're workaholics. You know, there just needs to be more balance. All right. That's what's needed for expansion here. Because, again, it's aligning yourself so that you're a vibrational match for what you want. It's time for you to start sending out new signals to attract what you need and what you want. That's the law of attraction. It says you're getting ready to move up into higher levels of awareness through embracing your life experiences. You are sending out new signals that are bringing forward positive new experiences. And when some of these people, especially from the past, start checking in with you, you should be on a different vibration so that they should know that they can't play with you. But that's all about you having boundaries. Some of you, your curiosity about people, especially from your past, is why you always get stuck in the past. It doesn't matter what they're doing. It doesn't matter why they're reaching out to you. None of that matters. Are they trying to build something with you? Probably not. Balancing act. Don't put all your eggs in one basket. And that goes back to, like I said, especially in this whole love triangle type situation that a lot of people are going through. Some of you, you're putting all of your attention on one person. And the person that you're putting all of your attention on, or that you're waiting for, they may not even be for you. You are worthy. It is time to stop feeling unworthy, unloved, and undeserving. Yeah, don't allow a lack of self-worth, value, or low self-esteem to have you settling for someone that's just not giving you what you want. Bumpy ride. Don't be afraid to make a change, regardless of how hard you perceive it to be. It can be fun if you allow it and let go of the resistance to it. Heart of compassion. There's many people around you who benefit from your loving, compassionate heart. And number 8 here, follow the signs. Look around you for clues. The answer to your question is right in front of you. Yeah. Some of you need to not let your heart of compassion take you on this bumpy ride with somebody. This is a test of your own loyalty, your commitment, and how worthy you are to yourself. In understanding that you should not be giving up all of your peace, your happiness, to satisfy another person. Something here, if you are not careful and don't follow the signs, you're going to end up on a very bumpy ride. You need to know that you're worthy of what you want, so that you rise above whatever this situation is that's either in your life or coming back around or about to come into your life. There's a clarity that you need about a current situation. And when you see it from a higher perspective, it's going to really help you. Like I said, for some of you, and I've talked about this before, you're going to have to know the difference between helping people who are trying to attach themselves to you, and you're letting them into your life because of your heart of compassion, versus you having a heart of compassion to actually help people who have been assigned to you. Those who are attached to you is very different from those who are assigned to you. Sometimes God will assign people to you, and maybe it seems like they're not quite equally yoked with you. But it's a balancing act. They bring something to the table that you need, and you bring something to the table that they need. Some of you, what you have is just what somebody else wants, and they already have it. They just want more of it, so they're coming to you. So some of you, you have a person that could be well off financially, but because you have the gift to manifest abundance, whenever they want more wealth and abundance, that's when they come to you. People who are assigned to you, there's differences. They don't have something that you have, and vice versa. Be careful of people who have what you have, but they just want more, or they want to do better. Especially they want to do way better than you. Only so that they can keep you at a certain level. That should really help you when you're at a crossroads trying to decide which way should you go. Ask yourself, why is it that somebody else is in a relationship, but they want to be in a relationship with you at the same time they're in a relationship with somebody else? That's somebody who cannot, they're insatiable. They can't be satisfied. Nothing makes them happy because they lack their own self-worth and value. So what they're getting at home with someone else isn't enough. They want what you have too, to add to whatever they already have. That should tell you right there, that's not that's not gonna bring you any type of happiness, peace, or harmony in your life. You're not being chosen by that person. Why is it that this person has wealth, abundance, you know, popularity, fame, or whatever, but they still want to come and start a business and everything with you while they hide you? Why? Because they want your energy. They don't want a life with you. They don't want a partnership with you. They want your energy. And that's the energy that they're going to take and put into other partnerships. That's different from you meeting a person, and right now you don't have much money, but they're wealthy, and they're telling you, hey, I can help you get funding for a business. And you telling them, well, I have a creative idea. And the two of you, you come together and you're business partners. That's yin and yang energy. That's feminine and masculine energy. A lot of people are conditioned to believe that you need to go after a person that's just like you. That's not true. Why do you need another version of you? Need someone with morals and values and standards like you. But if they come to the table with exactly what you have, then how is that really benefiting you? Usually you need someone to come in and compliment you because you're missing something and they're missing something. I hope that makes sense. Look, collaboration. You're meant to collaborate with some people, but visualize, what does that collaboration for you look like? What do you desire in teamwork, collaboration, and partnership? Is it an exciting opportunity for you? Okay, because something here is most likely, it's a blessing in disguise. It's a blessing in disguise that someone rejects you. That's protection. For some of you, it's a blessing in disguise that you work with a person, even though when you judge this book by its cover, it may not be what you think it is. Like, I'm seeing this situation, how it's gonna unfold for a lot of people. It's very cliche, very storybook, fairy tale-ish. So something that you feel is just way too good to be true or impossible is going to be very true, and it's like the impossible becomes possible. Yeah, you and your loved ones are safe. I'm telling you, you have about 8 weeks to make a huge lifestyle change here. Yep, the end of a tough cycle approaches. I told you. And then here you have, it's time to take action and believe in the impossible. A new start is coming. Show the world the real you. We just had, this is full moon in Aquarius. We just had a full moon in Aquarius last week. A new start is coming. New moon. We have a new moon in Leo next week. New moon in Aries. New moons is all about manifestation. And then here's a full moon in Capricorn. Okay. The end of a tough cycle approaches. Capricorn energy being the devil. This is obsession. It's bad habits. It's bad financial health. It's overworking. It's overeating, oversleep, whatever it is. That cycle in your life is ending if you want it to end. Okay. Yeah, look, a time for healing. What do you need to release? Something from your south node has to be released, because right now you're very close to achieving your goal. And you have to be able to step out of your comfort zone to get into your north node. But you have to know that you're good enough, Virgo. So this is time for just soul work and activations to take place. You're good enough for whatever you're visualizing. You are good enough. If you tell yourself it's too good to be true, it's going to be too good to be true. Okay, so I hope that this message gave you more hope, clarity, insight, and awareness. This is really, really good. Happy healing to everyone. I hope that this harvest season is beautiful and amazing for every single person that watches and tunes in. Please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Always go within so that you never go without. I love you guys all so much, and I will see you on the next one. Bye.